The Election Commission has chosen to hold elections in four states in two phases. First will be Maharashtra and Haryana, then will be Chhattisgarh and J&K. A big cloud over the date of J&K because keeping in mind the current calamity that the state is facing. Now, emboldened by the successes in the Lok Sabha polls, BJP is flexing its muscle in Maharashtra. In nearly three decades of the alliance with the Shiv Sena in the state, the Bharatiya Janata Party for the first time is likely to contest an equal number of seats as its ally. Currently, the Congress has 82 seats in the Maharashtra Assembly. Its ally NCP has 62, Shiv Sena has 44 and BJP 46. The seat-sharing arrangement may change after the Assembly polls. Well, let's cut across from Maharashtra. Let's take you down to Haryana. One of the most interesting battles would be lined up in Haryana there. Now, one of the few remaining Congress bastions, Chief Minister Bhupendra Singh Hooda, is eyeing a third term win, but it will not be that easy as the BJP is looking to harness its Lok Sabha successes in the very state. Amit Shah has already broken the alliance with Kuldeep Bishnoi's Haryana Janhit Congress. Prime Minister Narendra Modi over the last 2 months has been seen holding a number of rallies in the state. Now let's take you through the current political dynamic as it exists. Congress has 40 states and the BJP just 4. It will be interesting to note and see if BJP can change the fortunes in the state of Haryana this time around. Amit Shah is extremely confident that he can do it. All right, let's cut across. My colleague Kamlesh Sudhar joins us from Maharashtra, Mumbai, with the very latest going on there. In our studio is Javed Ansari, our executive editor, who's going to give us larger perspective. I'd like to cut across to Kamlesh at this point of time. Kamlesh, very interesting play of politics in Maharashtra. In just the next 5-10 minutes, we'll know what the dates are. But politically, with what's been playing about in the last 2-3 weeks is extremely interesting. The combat between Congress and NCP, things not going well there. And the same thing where the BJP and the Shiv Sena is concerned.
Well, yes, Preeti, the bickering is likely to end as the election dates are announced. But yes, the fact remains that both Congress, NCP and Shiv Sena, BJP, the alliance are exerting pressure on each other to get maximum number of seats, whereas the Congress, NCP the NCP leaders say that they are not going to take it lying down this time. They want equal number of seats, and the same situation is with the BJP, which says that it has been playing the small younger brother for last 15 years, and now they don't want to be in that role anymore because the BJP has performed well in Maharashtra. But also the BJP and Shiv Sena this time around have some smaller parties with them, which what they call as the Grand Alliance or Mahayuti. Smaller parties like the Swabhimani Shetkari Sangathan or Mahadev Jankar's RSP and Republican Party of India Athavale faction. These smaller parties are going to make a lot of difference as they made in the Lok Sabha elections. But let us wait and see whether they arrive at a conclusion. But this time around, the seat sharing pattern is likely to change once the date are announced.
All right, you know, do stay on with us. We're also joined on the phone line by Siddharth Vardarajan, senior journalist. I'd like to quickly cut across to Javed Ansari, our executive editor first. You know, Javed, just about 4 days back, Amit Shah has gone on record to say that formation of governments in these four states will be the achievement of the next stage of the BJP agenda of Congress-free India. Now, that kind of confidence is derived from credible number of factors, aren't they? Because the BJP is riding a wave.
They are riding a wave. Mr. Narendra Modi continues to enjoy the highest popularity ratings in the country. And they also have to, you know, they're faced by the Congress, which is demoralized, buffeted by a major defeat in the Lok Sabha elections. In Haryana, they've been in government for 10 years, in Maharashtra for 15. So for 15 years. So the anti-incumbency factor is something which is staring the Congress in the face. Congress and in Maharashtra, they haven't even got their alliance in place. They haven't even got their seat-sharing alliances in place. So therefore, there's a lot of groundwork that the Congress has to do. For the BJP, they are riding away. But if on the back of what happened in Bihar, if they were to lose one of the two states, then questions will start being asked of Mr. Modi and Mr. Amit Shah's game plan and their popularity.
You know, do stay on with us. Let's cut across to Siddharth Vardarajan at this point of time. Siddharth, incumbency burden of the Congress, motivated cadre, continuing appeal of Narendra Modi factor. Do you reckon all of this will come to the fore when these four states go to election?
Well, absolutely. I think that the Modi factor may or may not be as pronounced in the state elections as they were in the Lok Sabha elections, because certainly judging by by-elections in Uttarakhand or Bihar, the national Modi wave hasn't really carried over to at least those by-elections. So my sense is that, but having said that, there are plenty of objective reasons why the Congress Party in Haryana and Maharashtra in particular should be extremely worried about their prospects. They are racked by infighting, defection of senior leaders in Haryana, for example, allegations of corruption, allegations of poor governance, and in the context of the general defeat of the Congress and the loss of faith in the party at the national level, it's hard to see voters in at the state level reposing too much of faith in a leadership that they have seen hasn't quite delivered what they wanted over the last 10 or 15 years. So it's an uphill battle. These are elections that are there for the BJP to lose, quite frankly, as of now. But a lot will depend ultimately on, you know, perennial questions of alliances.
Right.
Haryana, for example, the BJP's Janhit, Haryana Janhit Congress alliance is broken up. So is that going to be a factor? Candidate selection, all of these will matter at the margin. But I still feel that these are elections that are there for the BJP to lose. Otherwise, the party should have a fairly easy time romping home.
But Siddharth, taking off from what you said about alliances there, do you reckon there's a state bit of maybe overconfidence where the BJP is concerned, citing the example of them breaking their alliance